Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Patreon webinar. It is your host Francesco here. So I will just want to start with a few updates when it comes to the Patreon side of stuff. I'm currently undergoing a move for a house, but the most important thing I want to do over the next couple of weeks is redesign how the Patreon works. So you guys will be getting an update about how this is going to be changing over the next couple of weeks. We are considering two separate things: to either continue growing the Patreon in terms of making it a bit more open and improving your experience, because I don't think, in my opinion, you guys have been getting the best value out of this. So I want to make a better community and build out the sort of resources that you have available to you, and that will come in an exciting format. And the second option is going sort of direct and actually creating this separate community that will be available through the website. But I'm a little less much of a fan of it. But I will be updating you nonetheless in the next couple of weeks. You guys have been an amazing support, and I don't think I've honestly given you the best sort of experience. And I think that's something that I want to change. So yeah, you will be guys getting an update very soon. So in this video, guys, what I thought I'd do with you is dive into how to build like a journal inside of Notion using the new database templates. Now, I know a lot of you guys already have sort of a journal experience inside of the Notion, but it's obviously something that you might want to create on your daily experience. But I know a lot of you guys use a template button already. I'm just being able to use it every single day to create this new page that has all the information, but this can be done inside of templates, and I think it could be quite easy. So let's go ahead and create a brand new page and call this one journal, and we're going to add a lovely book to it. So let's type in book. Let's add this really nice orange one. So what I'm going to be doing in this video is I'm actually going to be pulling it from a database. So I'm going to go ahead and create a database, and we're going to create a table view for now. So I'm going to call it entries. So we're going to give it a name. We're going to call it, this is the entry, and we're going to give it we're going to give it a due date first. So we're going to move this one here, call it entry title, and we're going to give it a due date, or actually a log date, because that would be the date we're actually logging it on. Then what we're going to do here is also add any images, because I know a lot of you guys sometimes like to have images inside of your journal. So you're probably wondering, okay, you've got the basic setup in terms of, you know, adding a log and things like that. So for example, let's say you want to go ahead and add a new entry. You could go in here and type in, you know, walk up to Liscard. And you could add the log and any images. And then down here, you could start doing it. But that's really what I want to solve with this feature day, is show you how you could create some sort of prompting system that would allow you to create a basic journal experience. And do remember with this, you don't necessarily, we created a basic table view, but let's go ahead and create a gallery view out of this, sorry, a calendar view out of this, so you can start to see your entries inside of this view. So you can see here, walk up to Liscard. I don't know what I had there. So if I just put a tree, there's a lovely tree there. So as you can see here, you've got a bit of an idea of a calendar view here. So I'm going to go to the three dots and just go to properties and have the log date there, so it's a bit easier. So what we're going to do now is we're actually going to go over to the new database templates area. And as you can see, we've got an empty page, but we're going to go ahead and create a new template. So this is for anything that will be created in the log date. So in this case, I'm not going to give it a due date. So I'm going to clear there. So I'm going to keep these two empty and keep the title, maybe title it new entry template, so I know what's coming, and maybe a little sort of post box there. So what I'm going to do with this bit is I'm actually going to break it down into quadrants. So the main reason I want to do this is because it's like an application called Grid Diary. So for example, Grid Diary, what they do is they ask you questions that will help you to make a better journal experience. So this one could be, what am I most grateful for? Question mark. And what I'm going to do is actually I'm going to copy this and paste it. So I've got the heading 3 ready to go. And I'm going to say, This one could be, did I work out today? And maybe I'm going to add a few more. Just give me a moment. Okay, so I think I'm pretty happy with these. I'm going to turn them all into heading threes. So this is a good starting point. What I'm going to do is what Grid Diary does and turn them into almost this grid view. So what I'm going to do is just work out how to capture this one. So sometimes this can be a little bit fussy. It was being a bit of a pain here with me. But as you can see here, I've got sort of five core areas which I can start filling in every time I create a new template. And what I might do here is go ahead and add like an orange background. And maybe if I wanted to go full customization, add a blue text to it. Or I could just have blue text. I don't think you can do the both at the same time. But let's just put blue backgrounds in this case for all of these. Okay, so you can start to see I've got a bit of an entry here, and every time I add a new entry, it's quite a neat way to be able to do this. So if I go back out of this, and let's say I want to add a new template, let's just pull this one back to another day, and let's go say I want to add a new entry for today. So as you can see, this appears, and I can say boxing up the house, because that's what I was mainly doing today, and I'll bring a box in, and as you can see there, I'm also going to add the log date, so that's what I would do. Any images that I necessarily need to, which I don't have any. And I could go, okay, what am I most grateful for? Okay, I'm really grateful for having a house over my head. And what I can do here is actually that should have come underneath there. So this is something that you probably need to set up inside of the template, something that I didn't do. And you can put here, did I work out today? No workouts. And as you can see, you can start filling this in quite easily. So this is actually one of the best ways to use it. If you're not looking to follow that sort of structure, that's absolutely fine. You can go ahead and create a new template. You might want to have a template that's like questions for you. You might want to call it questions. And you might want to call this one, this new template, new log. And this might be a nicer sort of more, sort of story today, you could put. And you could tell a story of the day. And you might want to put, you know, a purple background there, a divider here, and of course add any images. You can add some blocks here for images so that it's like ready for if you want to tell a story for the day. And you can see what, you can get what I mean here. You might want to put another image down here and one over here. And for example, you might want to say at the bottom, like useful reads, add a divider below it, and add a pink background there. And you can start to see here, you've got this bit of a different type of log here. But you can structure this however you like. And what's great as well is if I go ahead and create a new log, I can start adding that sort of story to here. Now, if you didn't add a date to it, you can obviously find it here. It will automatically be added to the day that you're hovering on, and you can go in and add the entry. So guys, this is a neat way to create journal entries. As I said, this is fairly brief. I will be updating at the Patreon, as I mentioned, very soon. You guys will be hearing about what we're planning for the Slack and also other things like that. Anyway, guys, a big thank you for being Patreon subscribers. Let me know if you have any questions. You know you can always email me at francesco@keepproductive.com. And I'll happily help any questions you have. Cheers, everyone. Make sure to have a great day. Keep productive. I will see you guys super duper soon. Cheers, everyone.